Yes, good morning, students. In continuation with the topic we started yesterday, we are going to carry on with the tenses. So yesterday we did present tense and past tense, right? So as I already told you that tenses, you know, they have been divided into three zones. Tenses are actually the time periods. So the time zones, there are three time zones. One is present, one is past, and one is future. Present is the time which is going on now. Past, something which is over, and future, which is yet to come. But when we talk about the time zone called present, it means that it's not just about what's happening now. It's also about like what happened earlier, but has its connection with the present. Or it is about the time factor which started in the past and is continuing in the present, okay, along with some time element given, right? So when we say, I have done my work, so I have done my work, so let it not be just future first. If I say, I have done my work, I guess you all know that which tense is it? It is present perfect tense. It's present perfect. Why perfect? What's the meaning of perfect in layman? Perfect means something which is done. Something which has reached perfection. Perfection is when something is accomplished. Okay, when you've done something, then it is, you say like, it's perfectly done. Okay, when you've reached 100% target, you say perfect, it's perfect. So perfect means when something is done to 100% satisfaction, right? In layman. But when we talk about tense, present, perfect, it means that it talks about the time when something has been done to completion. When something is completed and it has its connection with the present, okay? Because present, I gave you one example yesterday also, like I have done my work and ma'am, you can check my notebook. There is no doubt whether you did your work or not. I have done my work and you can check it. You can see this. I have prepared, I have cooked food. Now you can eat it. I have made tea. You can have it. Right? So it means that if I say I have made tea and you can have it. If I say I have made tea, it means that the cup of tea is ready. Right? But the making of the tea is over. The action of making tea is over. Otherwise, you may say like it's past, but it's not past because the cup of tea is in our hand. That's why it is present, but its making is over. So perfect because its making is over, present because it's still there. Right? Suppose I say I made tea yesterday. Or you can simply say, yesterday, though, obviously you come to know that it is past. I made tea an hour ago. I made tea an hour ago means that making of the tea was over in the past, and moreover, it has no connection with the present because now tea is not there. It might have become cold. It might have become useless. You cannot have it right now. I made tea an hour ago. Got it? I made tea an hour ago means the tea, making of the tea was over in the past, number one. Number two, it is not there now. Why it's not there? Because it might have become useless. It might have got cold and all. Got it? So I made tea an hour ago. So there is a difference. I have made tea and I made tea. This is present perfect and this is past indefinite. Past indefinite. So where is the difference in these two sentences, tense wise? Here it is present and here it is past. What's the difference in their meaning? It means that the tea is there. You can have it. It means that the tea now you cannot have. Either it has become useless or you have finished it. It has got finished. Got it? So present, though the action is over, but yet it has its relevance in the present. But when we talk about present, past indefinite, then the things are over in the past. Making was also over. And now it is not there also. It's useless. When you say, I have done my work, it means that you've done the work and you can see this. I have written it on blackboard, children. I have written means I have written. My writing work is over. The process of writing the things on the blackboard is over. And you can see this. But suppose I say, I wrote it on blackboard. What does it mean? That I wrote it on blackboard maybe an hour ago, maybe just 5 minutes ago. But the point is that when I wrote it on blackboard, now it is not there. Okay? I wrote it on blackboard, children. Why didn't you notice the things? When I wrote it, why didn't you see? My point is that now you cannot see what I wrote, so you could have been careful. So try to understand the basic difference between present indefinite, present perfect, and past indefinite, right? Because these are the two tenses where children get very confused usually. Not only the children, even many grown-ups also commit the same mistake. I have done my work means that still you have, it's connected with the present. I did my work means that somewhere in the past, maybe 5 minutes ago, you did the work and now it's not there. You cannot show it. Got it? Suppose you don't bring your notebook to the class for checking and the teacher says, okay, beta, show me notebook for checking. You say, ma'am, it's not there. Then the teacher says, you might not have done the work. You say, ma'am, I did the work, but the notebook is not with me. You don't say that, ma'am, I have done the work. If you say I have done the work, then you'll have to show the notebook also. If you did the work, but the notebook is not with you, then you are to say I did the work, but I forgot to bring the notebook. Something like this, I mean. Got it? So now let's proceed to the next tense, which we were doing. And we also did yesterday present continuous and present continuous and past continuous also we did. So what is continuous? Continuous is something which is going on. When I say present continuous, it means that now the work is going on. When I say past continuous, then it means that the action is over. Janvi, yes. Yes, Janvi. Yes, you can unmute yourself. Yes.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, कल क्लास तो लगी नहीं थी.
Yes. When I say she has lived here all her life, it means that even now she is living there. Got it? And it's another version will be it. She has been living here throughout her life or since her childhood or since her youth. But because exact time element is not written, so we can say that she has lived her all her life. Even now she might be there. But when I say she lived here all her life, it means that she lived here all her life and now she might have gone somewhere else or she might have died. We don't know. But that person might not be there now. Past indefinite means in the past, not now. Present indefinite means in the past and even now. Is that clear? When I say she has lived here all her life, it means she was living here and she is living here. But when I say she lived here all her life, It means that she is no more now. Present perfect has connection with the present and past, but past indefinite has connection only with the past, not with present. Okay. So another tense which we discussed yesterday was that you people know a little bit, but still I must repeat. If I say I am I'm reading a book. I'm reading a book on Abdul Kalam. Okay? Or if I say I have been reading a book. Are these two sentences correct? Are these two sentences correct? Raise hand. Tell me, are these two sentences correct? If yes, why? If no, why? Yes, I'm sure.
Ma'am, the first sentence is correct. I'm reading a book. It implies that I'm reading a book right now. And in the second sentence, I have been reading a book. There should be a time range. Like I have been reading a book for the past few hours, something like this. Okay.
So will you say that the second sentence is correct?
Ma'am, it's half correct. It needs a time.
Ansha, you know the answer. 90% you are correct. Okay. So first part is very much correct. I am reading a book right now. Okay, no problem. I have a book and I'm reading it. And you don't mind like whether I started reading it yesterday, today. Since when I've been reading, you people don't mind it. I'm reading a book now. I'm teaching you right now. That's okay. But when I add time range or time element with this, then I'll have to say, I have been reading a book for 2 hours. Or since 2 o'clock, anything. So you have to complete the sentence with a time range, only then it will be correct. Otherwise, without time element, this is wrong. Got it? You must not say that, ma'am, I have been working hard. Bas. So that will be wrong. You should say, ma'am, I've been working hard upon English since my childhood, and that's why I'm so good in English. Got it? So now all of you make two sentences, one on present continuous. You people might be knowing that this is present continuous, and this is have been reading is present perfect continuous. Present because have or has are present. Perfect. Have, has, had. They are called as the perfect verbs. You can note down somewhere. If somebody asks you, like, what are the perfect verbs? What will you say? The perfect verbs are has, have, and had. And if somebody says, what are the present perfect verbs? The present perfect verbs are has or have. Past perfect verb is had. Okay? And whenever we use perfect verbs, we always use with them third form of verb. Okay? Perfect verbs always take third form of verb. Perfect verbs always take third form of verb. Right? Okay, so I have been. Why been is there? Because of have, we have to use third form of verb. Now, why reading? Why read plus ing? Because continuous is there. Whenever there is continuous, ing will be used. And whenever ing is used, first form always comes. there is children never any need to learn the tenses. 99% of the times children learn the rules of tenses, and the moment they forget something, they forget everything. There is no logic, there is no need to learn the rules, because the rules are there because of the logic. When you people say like the present perfect continuous, the rule is has been or have been plus v1 plus ing, why to do this kind of thing? When you say present perfect continuous, then you should know that the present perfect verbs are has or have, right? And present perfect verbs always take third form. So been will come with it, but there is continuous also. Because of continuous, v1 plus ing will be there. So has, have, been plus v1 plus ing, that will be the rule of present perfect continuous. So I wanted you people to write down two examples of present continuous and present perfect continuous. Come on. Okay. Send the message. Come on. Yes, send the message. Okay, so there is an example by Manavit. They are playing in the ground. It's present continuous, and they have been playing in the ground since morning. Yes, correct, Manavit. This is Dharya. I have been playing in the playground for 2 hours. Dharya, what is this? I have been playing in the playground for 2 hours. What kind of tense is it? It is present perfect continuous. And I am playing in the playground is present continuous. Okay. Janvi and Jia, they are saying it's raining outside. What kind of tense is it? It's raining outside. Present continuous. It has been raining since morning. That's correct. So rather night. It has been raining since night, isn't it? So today it's quite pleasant. Enjoy the sun, enjoy the rain along with the puras. Tell your mother to make that, right? So anyways, birds are flying in the sky, present continuous. They have been playing since 5 p.m., present perfect continuous. Yes, children, you people are all correct. But children, main thing is, it's not, I don't want you people to focus only upon the rules. Today, I want you people to understand the usage of the tenses. If you say, I'm doing my work, or if you say, I've been doing my work for an hour, there is a difference. And kindly do notice the difference. Okay? So now let's continue with the next tense. Now I'll pick up the tense future. When I say future indefinite, I simply mean that I have made up a mind to do something in the future. Okay, when I say I'll go there tomorrow. I'll go there tomorrow. It's simply my plan. It's not like it's fixed. I'll go there tomorrow. I'll do this. Right? So when I have planned to do something in the future, that is future indefinite. There is nothing much to explain. Okay? It's simply your plan about the future. Okay? And children, all models, will, shall, may, might, can, could, must, they are all somewhere about the, future. When I say I can do this means I'm able to do this. So I can do this also denotes not the past or present. It also denotes somewhere future. Okay. And moreover, models are about the mood. That we'll discuss some other time. So I'll go there, I shall go there. There is not much difference. Okay, when we'll discuss the models, then we'll talk about the, various other kinds of the, various other rules related to will and shall. Okay, so I'll go there. We shall work hard to get good marks. So determination, right? So whenever indefinite is there, we use first form of verb with V1. Will plus first form. So whenever future indefinite tense is there, then only with will or shall, we use first form of verb. Always remember that all modals take first form of verb. Will and shall are also modals. All modals take first form of verb. Learn it. It may be will or it may be would. It may be shall or should. They take first form of verb, right? So after will or shall, first form, now we can pick up another tense, that is future continuous. What is future continuous? I will be watching TV in the evening. So when you think about like what will be happening in the future in the evening, so that is also like what will be going on sometime in the future. So there also you say, I'll be watching TV in the evening and I'll be playing a game of chess with my brother, or I'll be having my dinner with my family. So I don't think I'll be free in the evening. Got it? So point is like, what will be happening at that point of time, what you are talking about. Suppose your friend says, Tushar, I'll come to your house at 5 o'clock. You say, no, don't come to my house at 5 o'clock, because at that time, my mother will be teaching me. Okay, my mother might be teaching me. My mother will be teaching me. So don't come. So future continuous is about the things which will be going on, but in the future. So here the rule is will or shall. So whenever we talk about the word future, we use will or shall always, right? And with will, shall, we always use first form of verb. But here, because of continuous, we'll be using V1 plus ing. Because of continuous, V1 plus ing. Then where will the will or where will the first form of will, shall go? Where will the first form of will and shall go? It will go into be. Will be or shall be plus V1 ing. I will be watching TV in the morning, in the evening. Got it? So future continuous rule is simple. Either will or shall plus be. Don't forget be. Right? Third is future perfect. What is, I told you, what are the perfect verbs, children? Come on. What are the perfect verbs? Come on, send the answer. What are the perfect verbs? Yes, has, have, had. Well done, Manavik. The perfect verbs are has, have, had. And what are the future verbs? Yes, Gaurav, correct. Come on now, tell me, what are the future verbs? Come on. Will, shall. Very good, Manavit. So future verbs are will or shall. And what are the perfect verbs? Has or have. But with will, shall, we'll be using only have, not has. We are to say future perfect. With will, shall, we use first form. And first form has come in have. With perfect verbs, we always use third form. And it will come in the been. We have been. Or it could be third form. Simply third form it could be. Okay. So we will have done our work in the evening. When you say, okay, when your friend says, okay, Harshit, will you give me your notebook in the evening? And Harshit says, yeah, of course, I'll have done my work. I will have done my work. Come and take the notebook. Got it? So children, last 1 minute is left. So future perfect tense is will or shall, have plus third form of verb. So one future perfect continuous is left that we will discuss some other time. Now you people revise all the tenses. You may check the video again and I'll be sending you the homework, okay, in the group. So from the book, you know, you'll be given the work to be done. Open your grammar books today and there the work will be done. Is that clear? Will you do that? Okay. Thank you very much. Take care. And this week your test will be of all the, remember, whenever there is a test each week, the test will be of the topics we are doing each week. Okay. There is nothing to be told like which test will be there. Whatever we are doing daily, that will be the test.